Hi friends, welcome to the business studies class. In this module we are going to learn about the another form of business organization, that is joint Hindu family business. Joint Hindu family business is a specific form of business organization found only in India. It is one of the oldest form of business organization in the country. It refers to a form of organization wherein the business is owned and carried on by the members of joint Hindu family. It is governed by Hindu law. The base of membership in the business is the birth in a particular family, and three successive generations can be members in the business. The business is controlled by the head of the family, that is, who is the eldest member, and he is known as Karta. All members have equal ownership right over the property of an ancestral, and they are known as co-partners. Now we are going to learn the important features of joint Hindu family business. The first important feature of joint Hindu family business is formation. For a joint Hindu family business, there should be at least two members in the family, and ancestral property is to be inherited by them. The business does not require any agreement, as membership is by birth. It is governed by Hindu Succession Act 1956. Next point is liability. The liability of all the members except the Karta is limited to the share of co-partnership property of the business. The Karta, however, has unlimited liability. Next, we are going to learn about the important advantages of joint Hindu family business. First point is control. The control of the family business lies with the Karta. He takes all the decisions and is unauthorized to manage the activities. His decisions are binding upon the other members. Next point is continuity. The business continues even after the death of the Karta, as the next eldest member takes up the position of Karta. Leaving the business stable, the business can be terminated with the mutual consent of the members. Another point is minor members. The inclusion of an individual into the business occurs due to birth in a Hindu undivided family. Hence, minors can also be the members of the business. Next point is minor members. The inclusion of an individual into business occurs due to birth in a Hindu undivided family. Hence, minors can also be the members of the business. The advantages of joint Hindu family business are, first one, effective control. The Karta has the absolute decision-making power. This avoids conflicts among the members, as no one can interfere with his right to decide. Thus also leads to prompt and decision-making. Second point is continued business existence. The death of the Karta will not affect the business, as the next eldest member will then take up the position. Hence, operations are not terminated and continuity of business is not threatened. Next point is limited liability of the members. The liability of all the co-partners except Karta is limited to their share in the business, and consequently their risk is well defined and precise. The liability of the Karta is unlimited, and other members' liability is limited to the amount of capital invested in the business. Next important merit is limited liability of the members. The liability of all the co-partners except the Karta limited to their share in the business, and consequently their risk is well defined and precise. Next important merit is increased loyalty and cooperation. Since the business is run by the members of a family, there is a greater sense of loyalty towards one another. Pride in the growth of the business is linked to the achievement of the family. This helps an insecure better cooperation from all the members. These are the important points included in the merits or advantages of joint Hindu family business. Now we are going to learn about the important limitations of sole proprietorship business. First point is limited resources. The joint Hindu family business faces the problem of limited capital as it depends mainly on ancestral property. This limits the scope for expansion of business. Second point is unlimited liability of Karta. The Karta is burdened not only with the responsibility or decision making and management of business, but also suffers from the disadvantages of having unlimited liability. His personal property can be used to repay business debts. Next point is dominance of Karta. The Karta individually manages the business, which may at times not be acceptable to other members. This may cause conflict among them and may ever lead to breakdown of the family unit. The last limitation is limited managerial skills. Since the Karta can't be the expert in all areas of management, the business may suffer as a result of his unwise decisions. His inability to decide effectively may result into poor profits or even losses for the organization. These are the important demerits of sole proprietorship. Thank you.